Hold on, hold on, hold on. Did you see Kia's new badge? How did you see it? Isn't it great looking from maybe the future? Anyway, welcome to EV6 video series, Kia's first dedicated electric vehicle and its iterations. They have finally arrived not far off from the sibling, the Ioniq 5, okay? Hello and have a seat with AutoStop. We're glad to have you stopped by to check on what we have here. And let's consume what the electric world has offered us today, okay? In this episode of the EV series, we'll be looking at the world premiere of the Kia's EV6, EV6 GT, and then the EV6 GT line, and we'll highpoint the very relevant areas in the EV business. Kia actually came up with some mind-blowing feats, and we hope these numbers live up to expectations in the real world where these cars really live. We'll elucidate on that in a jiffy. However, here are some of the examples that came out and they were mind-blowing. For example, the over 510 kilometers distance over a full charge is great if it's able to live up to it. We've got the ultra fast charging, which can give you an equivalent of 100 kilometers in less than 4.5 seconds. That also mind-blowing. And then you have the high performance versions that can do a blistering 3.5 seconds for 0 to 62 mph or 0 to 100 kmh in acceleration. Okay, we're looking forward to the fulfillment of these numbers in the real world. Now, 2021 electric cars made history in so many ways and so many areas, and we look forward to 2022 electric vehicles of electric cars bringing something new also to the table. And these days, car makers are always looking at beating each other to the world technology of advancement and writing their name in history. Okay, so let's go find out what records Kia broke and wrote in the electric cars space. Okay, interestingly, the name tag EV6, so simple, so easy to pronounce, smart one for Kia. But why 6 and not any other? 5, 2, 3, all other numbers, but 6. Maybe a Kia executive somewhere will tell me that. Let's mind your business, okay? Right, anyway, the EV6, as we all know, is Kia's first dedicated EV, built on the Electric Global Modular Platform, the EGMP. And firstly applied to the EV6, Kia's new EGMP platform allows for a flat floor, which enables varied interior designs. So just let's have a look with the footage that they used to explain it. Okay, so regardless of the EV's compact exterior dimensions, its 2.9 wheelbase, as seen there, results in a cabin space similar to many mid to large SUVs. Okay, so do you really discern what that means for you? Yeah, more and more and more interior room for you and your passengers in this case. Okay, I would have gone for technological innovation, but Kia decided to go with spatial innovation. So how do they achieve this spatial innovations? Let's just take a look at it. Okay, they came up with what we call the panoramic dual 12.3 curved display, which is beautiful in there. Kia has done a good job for what we are looking at, and it has a wide high definition design. The wide high definition design of the EV6 dual curved display provides clear unobstructed visibility while providing intuitive menus and visuals. Then again, the center console has a LCD tactile touch surfaces, which makes the interaction with the infotainment very interesting and lovely. Okay, now we move on to the materials that were used, which I believe are sustainable and the executives are so much in love with. The seats are made from recycled PETs, high quality vegan leather and suede. Okay, so that's what is beautifully going on, and there, and that's interesting. Okay, yeah, so that is it. Ultra fast charging is something I think is extremely important. It's one of the problems of the industry, the EV industry. And so when they came up with the 800 voltage high speed multi-charging system for the EV6, which enables you to find extra time to do other things when you are charging, is great. The quick charge which charges in less than 4.5 minutes would give you 100 kilometers of driving range. I understand it takes less than 18 minutes to charge from 10 to 80%. This should not be called fast charging. It should be called warp charging. Okay, warp charging. Right. Now, so that's one of the relevant areas where they've dealt with in a way that I believe is great. How about range? It does 510 kilometers on a full charge with a 77.4 kilowatts battery models, and the 58 battery kilowatts models also have enough to cover for all your driving needs in a day. And this comes in whether it comes in either rear wheel drive, which runs on a single electric motor, or an all wheel drive that rides on a dual electric motors, which is based on the WLTP and is pending the homologation. Final AER figures and energy consumption figures are yet to be communicated. All right. Now, another interesting component is the convenient power supply for your activities, which I believe is clever and intelligent. I mean, to have a standby emergency power source is great. The EV6 is equipped with vehicle to load, that is a V2L function that works as a convenient portable electricity supply for your daily life or leisure activities. It can also serve as an emergency power source for your home, as is being demonstrated in here. And it can give you 3.6 kilowatts of electricity and works as a portable generator when you're doing any outdoor stuff, right? Now, the towing capacity is around 1600 kg, but not for all the models. It's dependent on the configuration and the drivetrain that you have, okay? So these are the areas where I think should be high pointed at this point in time. Auto stop will add on when the vehicle becomes more accessible to the general public, and we'll pitch this against the Ioniq 5 and the Mark E and the ID4, which in a later video. Okay, we however have reviewed the 2021 Mustang Mark E. If you are interested, we'll put the link in the end of the video so you can follow it. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great time. Until we meet again, same time. Bye bye. Bye-bye.